chat. You did such a spectacular job in this. I could not stop laughing. And I have to ask you, it had to have been refreshing for you to start off playing her so uptight and then let her flow the way she did.
I actually, what I loved about it was that she, absolutely uptight. Very, like he said, wound like a top. But she is kind of goofy and she's kind of quirky and she has these little things that she does. Yeah. And when she lets her guard down a little bit, she is so naturally sort of fun. And,
exactly.
And I love that that's what Mike ultimately fell in love with. He didn't fall in love with the hair and the boobs and the ass. He fell in love with this quirky, silly girl that does a stupid spazzy dance. You know?
I was going to say, my favorite part by far was the goofy dance.
Yeah.
Okay, so did that just come from you? Or?
Yeah, it said in the script her spazzy dance. And I was like, well, what is spazzy? Like, what, let's talk about what level of spazzy you guys want here, because I can really spazz it out if you want. I could do like the lawnmower or
Right,
you know, like, what do you want? And so it just kind of got born from that. But we had it in a lot. I mean, there were a lot of Abby Spazzy dance moments.
Right.
And I think Robert was like, I had to cut them down a bit.
That's what we have the DVD for, though.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
We'll see the whole featurette.
The slew of
Abby Catherine
Spazzy
and the Spazzy dance. And also, you know, working with somebody like Jared Butler, I mean, oh, tough life. My heart really bleeds for you, you know. But seriously, you know, the sparks really flew. And I felt that it was very real. Did you just connect like that?
I think, I mean, I think Jerry and I just immediately from the start kind of just had fun together and laughed and had a good time. But he nailed that character so beautifully, and Abby was so uptight that it was so easy to sort of react the way you would react to somebody saying this crap to you. You know, if you had a guy saying stuff to you like get on a Stairmaster, you would mean you would have that sort of thing.
How dare you?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And what I loved again is that Abby ultimately sort of fell in love with the guy who she knew was putting on sort of a bravado and started to not take that bravado so seriously. She started to kind of, in the beginning, she was really kind of offended by it. By the end, she was sort of like, yeah, Mike, you know, and I loved the evolution of it.
And your physical comedy, oh my God, you were so funny in that underwear scene.
Oh,
lots of takes?
We did, well, like Robert said, we did 36 setups.
Get out.
You know, every different angle, and that's everybody's coverage around the table. That's under the table with the legs. That's Jerry's coverage. That's the little kid's coverage. And by the end of the day, I was pretty over it.
No, you're a happily married woman, thank goodness. I'm happy to hear. But what was it? How did you know Josh was the guy?
I don't know. It was kind of, it was very, you know, like lightning. And, I mean, I knew I was in love with him within 5 weeks. Mm-hmm. And I knew I wanted to spend the rest of my life with him within 9 months. I don't know. There's something about him. And even to this day, and, you know, you always have that niggling fear, like, are we going to get sick of each other? Like, this is a long life ahead of us, you know?
You work it out. 21 years.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
You work it out. There's ups and downs.
I feel pretty confident about it, though, because at the end of the day, even despite the arguments that we may have or those sort of snarky moments with each other or whatever, like, he is my best friend. And I've always hesitated to say that because I think it's kind of cheesy and cliched. But I woke up one day and I went, oh, shit, you are actually my best friend.
That's
this is
so
weird.
Nice. Now, in the end, very quickly, I love the poster for this because her heart's in his head, his heart's in the crotch.
Yeah.
Is that the way it really is, Catherine?
I think absolutely initially. Absolutely, it is. And on that first date, even up until like that sixth date, it is that way. But again, the evolution of their relationship, their hearts started to change and go into the right places when they started to actually appreciate each other and fall in love with who the person actually is, you know? Because there is no love without that.
It all ends up here.
Yeah, you might have great sex without that, but you're not going to have love without it. So.
You did such a good job. Congratulations
to you.
Lovely to talk to you.
You too.
Thank you, Catherine. Have a great day.
You too.
Thank you.